AK Freak.
This is the dance we're going to go over right now. AK Freak. This one was requested by Nick, I believe. Two wall dance, 64 counts. It's by Rachel McEnany White and Peggy Mundy. I like that it's very well structured, so we'll just get through this in a jiffy, a breeze. Except for the first several counts, those will be interesting. All right, we start, in fact, with according to the step sheet, and one. The reason for that is the dance ends on a kick. So it's kick, ball, cross, eight, and one. So that's actually where I am going to start us right now. At the end of the dance, your weight is on the left, and you kick the right to the diagonal for kick, ball, cross, tap, press. So that's eight and one and two. Your weight is on the left. We have eight and one and two. We have a lunge ball cross, and just to really nail that lunge, I like to stick my elbow into it. Lunge ball cross. Because you're already on your right for the press, so you need there to be a little something more to give you the lunge and cross, and that's what my elbow does. Anyhow, your weight's on the left, let's take it back to the top. Kick and cross tap step. Seven. Oh, it's not even a seven, because the kick is eight. Ha! I'll give you a ready go. Ready, go. Kick, ball, cross, tap, step, lunge, ball, cross. All right. Now, I believe they describe the next step as the left going out to the side. I like to think of it as like a touch, turn, and then a roll. And they describe the roll as sitting down and then being pulled up by your belt to get back to a standing position, and then the weight shifts to the left. Now, I think they say something like, you step out to the left and then you turn. But for me, it's just easier to think about it like a touch turn, because then I don't hang out on my left foot too long. So we did our lunge ball cross. We have something that happens on the left. We turn, we sit, we straighten, and our weight shifts to the left. Let's just get up to that point. Your weight is on the left, we're gonna do a kick ball cross. Ready, kick ball cross, tap, step, lunge ball cross. Touch, or whatever, turn, sit, up. But we're not going to be here very long, because we have ball rock, recover, ball back. Knee's going to go out in, then you're going to dip your right shoulder, out forward, ball walk, and we'll get to that ball bit in a moment. But we really just glossed over the part where the knee has to go out and then the shoulder goes out. I like that part, it's interesting. So we did the sit, the stand, and our weight's on the left, and rock, recover, and back, puh, 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 ball, step, walk, walk. Your weight ends on the left, left. So during that whole sequence, just think about the left taking priority, because the left is important in a lot of that sequence. Let's take it back to the time. Start with our kick. Seven, eight, and one, and two. Three and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight. So I've pointed out a few times how the left foot needs to stay in front of the right, because that's the direction we're moving in. All right, let's do it one more time from the top, raise the left, kick the right. Seven, eight, and one, and two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight. Your weight's now on the left. We have a three-quarter turn with a sweep. We start with a half, so we're turning over the left shoulder, stepping back on the right, sweeping the left foot from front to back, but then we keep going for the two count, an additional quarter. And they describe it as all being one fluid motion. So your weight was on the left, and for the counts one, two, we're turning over the left shoulder, stepping back on the right, and we're sweeping the left foot. So this will be one, two, and three, four is and side cross. When I first learned this, because I wasn't used to that rhythm, I kept doing one, two, three, and four. I don't think anyone would really notice if you did that on the dance floor. If you did that, it would look like one, two, three, and four. But by doing the and three, four, it syncs up with the music differently. So you have One, two, and three, four. We're going to side rock recover. Five, six. And it's not really a coaster step. It's not really a sailor step. It's behind side forward. If there's a name for that, I would love to know what it is. But the effect of it from the side rock is five, six, seven, and eight. It's bringing our momentum forward so that we can do a couple of presses like in Sugar Honey IT. All right, let's add that much together from the top. Weights on the left are going to do our kick. Seven, eight, and one, and two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight, one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Weights down on the right, we press left, recover, and right, recover, back, touch, back, touch, turn, touch, and cross. Let's just do that section from the Sugar Honey IT presses. Weight was on the right. We press one, recover, and right foot, recover. When we recover the second time, we're going to go into some back touches. Right touch, left touch, quarter, left touch, ball cross. Let's do that as one connected sequence again. Weights on the right, pressing left. One, two, and three, four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. If you would like additional styling, it's on the step sheet. I probably won't stress that as much in my dancing of it tonight, but there are some options there to really do some like that's for independent study, I would say. I should also note that in the earlier sequence, there's an option to do a body roll. After you've done your sit and you're doing your ball rock recover, they also note an additional body roll you can add. So you've done your sit, stand, and roll, and step, touch, touch, pop, pop. Again, check the step sheet. Very well written, as Rachel's dances always are. There's just all kinds of additional wisdom in there. All right, putting together from the top. Weights on the left, kicking. Six, seven, eight, and one, and two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight, one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, one, two, and three, four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. Weights now on the right. Okay, now we have a whole section of counts that are just pretty standard, they make sense, they're not a lot of weird anything that we've never done before. I actually have an additional hand motion to add to the beginning part. But from here, we go out to the left, right, so we're just shifting our weight, we step to the left, we shift our weight to the right, we turn a quarter. If you've ever learned the dance cruising, this pattern might feel a little like the figure eight turn. We have quarter, step, half, quarter, behind, quarter. Weight ends on your right. So let's just take it from the cross position, because we had and touch and cross. Your weight's on the right. These are all going to be whole counts in this section. I'll count you in. Seven, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Not too bad there. And then we have the syncopated Joey steps. I'm not sure where the Joey step got its name, but this is how I've heard them. It's like lock steps that all connect. So we have one and two and three, four. We're going forward on the left. Step, lock, step, step, lock, step. And we have whole counts. Rock forward, recover, back, back. And as we go back those next two times, we're really going to drop those shoulders back. So again, I'm facing toward you. You'll be facing away from me if you're following along. But when we do this later, you can skip to the part where I face the direction where you can follow me. Your weight's on the right, and we're going forward with Joey steps. One, and two, and three, four. Rock, five, six, back, seven, eight. Weight is now back here on the right. During this section later in the song, they say, I'm a freak, 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 that you know. So if you'd like to do a little bouncing or whatever during the figure eight turns, it kind of introduces some artificial syncopation. And then the Joey steps actually do sync up with the syncopation. So if we're going out from the cross position, we're stepping to the left, I'll count you in. Seven, and three, 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 three. That you know. Can I get a beep, 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 baby, back it up nice and slow. I just wanna. And then we have additional steps. Let's just take it up to that point. From, oh my goodness, the very beginning. We've learned so many counts already. You can believe it. Weight to the left, kick to the right. Six, seven, eight, and one, and two, three, and four. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight. One, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, and three, four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, and two, and three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Your weight's back on the right. Okay, we're gonna turn over our left shoulder one quarter, stepping the left to the side. We're gonna touch the right toe. Now, for the next bit, we're gonna go a quarter, stepping the right, and we're gonna turn an additional quarter, touching the left toe. However, because the left then immediately crosses, I think of it as a sweep. On the step sheet, your weight is on the right, and you have one, two, three, four, cross in, out, knee, roll, where we go in, out. It's like inevitable when I dance this at full speed, I do more like a turn, touch, step, sweep, cross, end up, knee, knee. So, now you know, it's actually a touch. Your weight was on the right, let's do that section again, turning and touching, seven, and one, two, three, four, cross, out, out, knee, knee. All right, so it was seven, eight. Okay, from here, we shift the weight to the left, and maybe there's something they're hitting in the music, but they also suggest straightening your right leg as if you're like vaulting off of it. One. We're gonna do a crossing shuffle. Two and three. We're gonna turn a quarter and step the left. Four. Four, your weight's on the left. And from here, I'll show you how I end up doing it, but also I'll show you how the step sheet describes it. It's like a samba step, cross side rock recover. Five and six, and then you cross the left over seven, and you're done, because we already did the eight, which was the kickball cross at the beginning of the dance. So taking it from the knee roll position, we had seven, eight. We rolled the knee in, out. We're gonna launch onto that left foot. One, cross two and three, turn four, five and six, cross seven, eight and one and two. Now, I don't know where I got this, but I always thought it was like a syncopated jazz box, or at least that's how I kind of do it. After the launch, you have one, two, and three, four. And I just think of this as like a jazz box with different syncopation. Cross, back, back, cross. Like if you did it as a slow jazz box, it would be five and six, seven, kickball, cross, bump, bump. But anyway, it's actually a cross side rock recover. Cross. I do more like a bump, bump, bump. Now you have a couple ways to do it. Let's put it all together from the top, shall we? Weights on the left, kicking the right foot. Six, seven, eight, and one, and two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, eight, one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, one, two, and three, four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two and three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five and six, seven, eight. One, two and three, four, five and six, seven, eight and one. It continues from there. The hand that I mentioned you can introduce into the beginning is optional. They put a parenthesis saying like easy option. Forget the hand. And it's during the lunge ball cross, you would reach as you're stepping out the left, and then you bring the right hand in toward yourself as you're turning. So from the top, it would look like eight and one and two, three and four, five, 6. If that makes a difference to you, if you'd like to add that in for styling, you are welcome to. Let's do it once to the back, and then we'll try it with slowed down music. Your weight's on the left. 6, 7, 8, and 1, and 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, and 2. All right. Music time. This is by Mr. Worldwide, Mr. 305. Pitbull, featuring Pitbull, and titled under Enrique Iglesias. The song is I'm a Freak. Who's it by?
Enrique Iglesias.
Enrique Iglesias. And who else?
Pitbull.
Mr. Worldwide. Alright, let's take that again, but slowed down, because we haven't done it slow yet. So we're gonna do that slower.
Enrique Iglesias.
There we go.
Pitbull.
Nice mellow ballad. About freakiness. Let's go.
Yeah, move your body like a miracle.
Rachel McEnany White. Song is I'm a Freak by Enrique Iglesias, featuring the Bull of the Pit, Pitbull. Thank you for taking this walkthrough. See you in the next one.